And here they are, dressed slightly differently. Very good morning to everyone.
Yes, four knights of the round table. We have Sir Percival, Sir Leon, Sir Elwyn, I think I've said that, Elyan, and Sir Gwaine. Morning all. Should we just get you to introduce yourselves and tell us a little bit about the character? You go first. Eoin.
I play Sir Gwaine. He's basically arrogant, egotistical, womanizing drunk.
Right, yes. Great explanation.
Yeah, well, I'm Irish, the stereotype.
And you?
Adetomia, I play Sir Elyan, and I guess a trouble magnet.
A trouble magnet, Rupert.
Yes. Wow. I play Sir Leon, and I am basically Arthur's right-hand man, per se, so...
Okay, and lastly, Tom on the end.
I'm Tom, I play Sir Percival. I guess I'm the strong man of the group. I always seem to be given things to lift.
Okay.
And stuff, and he's sort of a strong silent type, I'd say, yeah.
Now, I think this is a brilliant way of doing it, because you've all sort of bigged up your parts, haven't you?
Yeah, you'd be
like
very disappointed.
Main person in the show, yeah.
So, people are saying it's got a little bit darker this time round.
It's actually quite scary. We're reading the scripts, and it's actually quite scary this year. It's got, it's matured a lot this year. I mean, they brought us in, which made it much better, of course, at the start as well. But no, I think the whole thing has kind of taken a lift up. You know, they're shooting it on 35mm, and just the stories are much darker. And it's,
I think the show sort of matured with the audience, and so I guess as the original audience have got older, so has the show. It's got a much sort of darker tone to it.
Mm. And it's in a different time slot, isn't it, as well, which sort of reflects what you're doing with
yeah,
it.
Yeah,
you're
yeah.
doing with TV, you're back in the old Camelonian
time. I'm talking about TV. Is it also in a different time slot then?
Messing with history.
Yeah, that's not a good idea. It's terrible.
Now, can I ask Rupert, I'm looking at everyone's hair. Now, two have long hair, two have short hair. Yeah. What are the rules?
It's the yin yang you've got to have. Yeah, one or the other. Well, when I joined a couple of years ago, and I was quite excited because I was the one with hair, and then Eoin turns up. He takes the hair away from me, and then I was the tall one, and then he comes along. So I'm kind of now just an amalgam of the two of them.
And hair and beards. Does everyone have to have a beard? No.
Can you grow a beard?
Can you grow a beard? I think there was a little mix-up when we started, and I started with a beard, and then lost it a couple of days into filming.
Well, are you told? Are you given? I mean, it sounds a bit silly, but are you given instructions about what your facial hair is?
Can I be honest with you? After next week, I'm going to shave my head and shave my beard, and I can't wait.
Because you were forced to have it.
I can't see. You know, I go like this. I actually can't see what's going on, and it's beginning to get a bit frustrating.
Welcome to my world.
It's very difficult. I feel a lot of sympathy for you now.
Thank you.
I do.
Well, I think a lot of it's when I auditioned, I had a beard, and then they keep it. And in fact, at the beginning of this year, my hair was slightly shorter, and then they said throughout the series, now you've got to grow it back.
This is the contract.
But not even, a little bit, I think. They kind of don't want to change too much. They might go, who's this new kid?
Yeah. I can imagine. It would confuse people. And
I mean, you must have the same thing with your hair, though, right? They keep everything very consistent.
It's not in the contract. But, of course, in television news, beards are deemed to be not good.
Really?
So
you've been in for how many series now?
This is my third, so I joined in series two.
Right. When it first started out, I watched right from the beginning, I'm glad to say. When you joined second series, did you have any idea how hugely successful it was going to be, actually?
For me, no. I mean, I'd watched the first series and really enjoyed it, and then... You know, it's an amazing feeling on set because the people are, it's an amazing group of people. The crew are fantastic and everyone, it's just such a great unit, which is unlike a lot of jobs. And so you know there's something special when you join in the stunts. My first episodes were a huge jousting episode. So out in France, then these crazy stunts going off and you're going, this is amazing.
So who's got hurt? Has anyone got hurt doing anything so far?
Probably Rupert.
We've all had a lot of time of getting a knock or two.
Yeah.
Okay, but when you're jousting, knocks could
not
be presumably...
Great
this is the thing about the jousting.
I was going to say that most of the injuries have happened sort of offset rather than on it.
Because you're having too much fun?
I don't know.
It was that time you walked into the trailer, wasn't it?
Well, the trailer walked into me.
Was everyone a horse comfortable with horses when they went into the show? Because sometimes you hear stories.
In the audition, they say, can you horse ride? Of course I can.
Obviously.
Exactly. Yeah, I've been doing it since I'm this high.
Shetland ponies, I'm brilliant.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, I think once we got on there, you just sort of have to wing it a little bit. But they give us a few lessons anyway. So we
there's some awesome shots of you know kind of rearing horses.
And are you in those shots or is it a stunt?
I was going to say I think some of them are stunts and some of them were unintentional stunts.
Yeah.
And the whole thing about Merlin, it's really kicked off, hasn't it? There's a fascination. And I know it's partly to do with what you're saying about the quality of the product. You know, it's so beautifully filmed now. People love all that stuff, don't they? There really is. People dress up, don't they? Have you heard about these things? Well, they dress up specially and watch the programme in the outfits.
Well, we see also, because we film this castle in France, and so a lot of fans can come out and watch. And there are, I mean, some days over 200 people there and dressed up as various characters. And it's, I think that's what they're doing. But it's very, it's amazing to see. All these people dressed up as Gwen and as knights, and it's really.
But no one really dressed up as a knight. I mean, they usually dress.
That
up
was
as
me.
Gay.
That was you.
Listen, saw yourself in the mirror. Went, oh, that's cool.
It's on tonight. Thank you very much indeed for coming and to speak to us. And I know we've had to tear you away for the rugby, so I appreciate the last 5 minutes.
Thank you very much.
Not at all. Thank you.
Katie, who plays Morgana, has joined us here. And if you'd seen the studio a few seconds ago, there was only her here. And then, as if by magic,
knights.
Three knights appeared just like that.
I feel like a very large girl, actually.
Conjured out of nowhere. Hello.
Hello.
How are you? And welcome back, gentlemen.
Thank you.
What fun you have on set by the look of things. Is it like that?
You know, everything that you see is a pretty accurate representation of what we do during a day. You know, it is like playing with your mates on it's like being in school in a lot of ways. Mm. You know, you get paid to hang out with your mates and be a kid.
And you've been in the series, because I have watched it right from the start, right from the beginning. How has it been sort of seeing it change over it's series 4 now, isn't it?
Yeah, it kind of feels like it's grown up with us, you know, because from where we started was sort of this little show in Cardiff all about magic, and now where it is and it being so popular and so massive, it's nice that we've all kind of grown with it. And I know Rupert probably feels similar because he's been in it sort of almost as long as us, and it's a very relaxed feeling because you've grown with it, and, you know, I think you've probably grown up with your audience as well.
But the character, Morgana's character, has the most fun.
Yeah, you know that's true. That is absolutely true.
You guys are basically, you're honourable and decent and upstanding.
Yeah. And she was when I first met her in the show, and now...
Morgana's
lovely in series 2, yeah.
Being bad is far more fun. Come on, I think everybody's with me on this.
You've grown up, haven't you? So you've become more realistic, you've become evil.
Closer to myself?
Yes. I'm trying to help you.
Let's talk to the knights as well. If you do the introductions. Eoin, who do you play?
I play Gwaine, who, as I already said, is a womanising, alcoholic Irishman.
So he plays himself as
yes.
well?
Yes.
Well cast, that one.
And Tom on the end, you play...
Yeah, I'm Tom and I play Sir Percival, and like I said as before, I guess I'm the strongman of the group. He sort of brings a bit of muscle occasionally, and strong silent type.
Rupert, I want you to pick up your part because they all have been very successful.
I wasn't, and I'm trying to think. I play Sir Leon, who's like the main knight of Camelot. The pin-up, I would say.
Pick up Rupert because he came in to do one line in one episode, and he was so good and so popular, he's been in it for 3 years.
Really?
There you go. That's right. Picking
what
it
was
up.
The line?
I can remember it now, but the first line, I had one line to say on set and I messed it up in the first take and I thought, that's it, I'm never going to work again. And somehow they gave me more of a chance. It was the king commands your presence immediately. And I keep getting that line, they keep writing in every so often just to remind me where I came from.
How did you make that one sing? Because there's not much to go.
It was really hard, I literally knocked the door. If you see it, I'm so pale because my chainmail was literally pounding away. The king... it was like that. It was terrible. But, you know, I remember it now.
He's not like that anymore, though. I mean, you give him a monologue now, he nails it.
No.
Really?
Are there, Katie, costume issues? Because, you know, the guys have got to wear the chainmail and stuff.
No, she gets some great dresses.
I get a great dress. They're not entirely comfortable. Eating any food with a 24-inch waist in a corset is really quite problematic.
No, I'm
I mean, fair. It looks great, but, you know...
You
slip
that in.
Yeah, no, I like that. I was like, by the way, because it's never going to happen in real life, so I need everybody to know. But it is beautiful, and this year, it's actually much easier. My costume isn't as constrictive as it has been before, so I get to sword fight still in the dress.
And I'm intrigued. We talked a little bit earlier about the look, you know, the hair. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't know how to say this, Katie, but you kind of look like
Morgana.
I mean, I was sort of thinking maybe you look completely different in your normal life, but you look a bit like a kind of a...
I think that's the entire reason I got the part. I walked in and they were like, oh, we won't have to do anything with her. She looks evil already. I mean, that's kind of it.
Because you've got the dark hair and that thing going on.
Well, that's not my real colour, but we won't say much about that.
Oh, okay.
And just tell us about the stunts as well, because they're all it's all pretty impressive. How much of them do you get to do yourselves?
Depends, really, doesn't it? The fighting stuff, we get to do all the fighting stuff, really, majority of it. And then it's just, I think, really, a lot of the jousting things that they pop a guy on the horse, and then next thing you know, we're taking the helmet off, looking all.
But that's really good having long hair for that bit. We kind of release
it. These really great French stunt guys to do all the stuff that, and they make it look so cool. And we kind of sit there, have a coffee, and go, "Oh, Rupert, look what you just did! Oh, I did that. That was quite cool."
And then they spray sweat on your face, and you go, "Oh, that was hard."
Now, and all costume dramas have particular followings, don't they? People get very, very into the programmes. Mm. Downton Abbey, I know, there are people who dress up and sort of have their houses done up like Downton Abbey.
Do they?
Yeah, the whole thing. So do you have fans who go to extreme lengths? Yes?
Yes, we do. And actually, they're very creative. It's nice to see, you know, that somebody takes that much interest in what it is that you do.
What do they do?
Well, they'll dress up as you. And what I love is when they do a twist on it, like a girl will do a female version of Colin's outfit. You know, they take initiative with it, which is really, really great.
Just think Colin's a girl in this
dress. Have people get in touch with you who are into witchcraft and all that stuff?
I was at the press launch the other day, and I was signing an autograph, and somebody started speaking to me in Old English. And I'm going, you do know that's my character, not me. I have no idea what you're saying. And I'm trying to figure it out, and I'm going...
And this year, you're all moving to the latest time slot, so is it slightly darker than we've had before?
Yeah, no, it's definitely grown up. It's definitely got more adult. I mean, it still has all the fun things that you expect from Merlin, the lightheartedness and the comedy and everything like that, but it's definitely...
Look at me for the comedy. I'm a very serious character. What are you talking about?
It's been lovely seeing you here today, and good luck with the series. I'm sure it'll do fantastically well. And thank you for entertaining Mike as well.
It was great. Yeah, really brought into the spirit of it. It was really, really fun.
And thanks very much as well. I understand that Colin, of course, who plays Merlin, was on his way, but the traffic got the better of him. And thanks very much to Adetomia as well, who was here. But we didn't have a seat.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.